People say that when you look at the moon through a telescope for too long, that you could go mad. I think it's true, right? Because Patrick Moore, he looked at the moon for years and years and years, and one time I saw him do a shit on the sun. Stick around.
I hope I give you the shits, you fucking wimp.
Hello, and welcome to Werewolf Week, Day 5. And I thought I'd take a break from the Werewolf movie reviews to do a top 10 list, on my favourite Werewolf movies. So, here we go, my top 10 Werewolf movies. Before we get started, I just want to tell you that this is all my personal opinion. None of you have to agree with it. If you have your own top 10, then please do share down in the comments. So here we go, my top 10 Werewolf movies. Okay, so kicking it off at number 10, we got Bad Moon. Yes, 1996 Werewolf horror. And in this, an Alsatian, like, you know, just goes for that werewolf beast, you know, just like wrestling it. It's also got a little... It also does remind me a little bit of Terminator 2 when the mother's right protective of her son and she's like saying, put him down. Yes. Number 9, it is Teen Wolf. Probably the only family-friendly werewolf flick in this list. Michael J. Fox plays a teen in it who, well, just when you thought puberty was, you know, couldn't get any worse, he becomes a werewolf, but... All of a sudden, he becomes cool and makes the basketball team and uses his werewolf powers to do all that and stuff. And it's a family comedy. At number 18 is Wolf. Jack Nicholson plays some guy who gets bitten by a wolf and then all of a sudden gains wolf-like abilities and that. But once he falls in love with Michelle Pfeiffer, I think that's it. It's been a while since I've seen it, but... I do know that it's a wolf film, and that's when he realises it's a curse. At number 7, the Underworld franchise. Now, I couldn't really just settle on one. I mean, yeah, they do focus a lot on the vampires and that, but, you know, Rise of the Lycans shows us, you know, how the whole conflict began, and also how the Lycans came to be. You know, and, yeah, they're good films and that, great action-y stuff. Coming in at number 6, we have Ginger Snaps. Basically, you know, this is like teenage lifestyle and stuff and that. You know, starring Catherine Isabel, you know, who's like this bad, you know, like this bad girl who, like, you know, likes to take risks and stuff, and she's also going through a werewolf change, and, you know, instead of changing on the full moon, she actually slowly changes throughout the film, and that till she becomes a full complete wolf form. Bit like Cronenberg's The Fly, but she's turning into a werewolf. Number 5 is The Howling. Yes, I like this film a lot. It's one of the early werewolf films I saw, and I loved it. Dee Wallace and Patrick's, I can't remember his name, but he's an actor as well, and yeah, it's an enjoyable film. And, you know, I do like the ending when she's transforming into the lichen beast. Yes, The Howling. Coming in at number 4 is Van Helsing. So, this action horror, we see Hugh Jackman playing the legendary monster hunter Van Helsing, and basically he's he comes across Dracula, Frankenstein's monster, and the Wolfman, and even becomes the Wolfman at one point. We have 3 wolves in this I think the effects at the time good. Even went to the pictures to see this film. Coming in at number 3 we have the Wolfman 2010 remake. Now, like I said, I wasn't a huge fan of the original, which you can see what I did on day 3 of this week. I wasn't a huge fan of the original, but I thought the remake, to me, in my opinion, was way, way better. And I liked the effects in it. I liked how the Wolfman looked, you know, with Benicio del Toro and Anthony Hopkins and that. Especially the showdown they have. And coming in at number 2, we got An American Werewolf in London. Yeah, John Landis's finest. That gave us the iconic modern werewolf transformation, and even inspired Michael Jackson in the opening scene of The Thriller when he transforms into a werewolf. And of course, I like this film. It has a good soundtrack, dark comedy humour. Yeah, it's brilliant, and I can watch it and never get fed up with it. Before I get to my number 1 pick, I just want to give out some honourable mentions to some films that didn't make it, and they are The Wolfman 1941, Silver Bullet, An American Werewolf in Paris, and Cursed 13 Hours. Okay, and one dishonourable mention to The Twilight Saga. I don't need to explain why. So, number 1, it is Dog Soldiers. Yeah, one for the boys, you know, action stuff, you know, group of soldiers out on a training exercise soon find themselves hunted down by a pack of werewolves, and they take refuge in their cottage and start firing away. Yeah, dark humour, action, and werewolves. Yeah, I can always watch that film. I've never grown tired of watching it, and I love it to death. Yes. And that has been my top 10 werewolf films for, well, Werewolf Week. If you like this video, be sure to give it a big thumbs up and to share with your friends. And let me know what you think down in the comments below. Do you agree with the list? Are there any I should have mentioned? Anyway, yeah, like I said, be sure to subscribe to the channel, hit the notification bell. All of my social media links, the Random Horror Madhouse Facebook group, my Twitter, my Instagram, all linked down below, so be sure to check all that out. And until next time, do have nightmares.